Hello everyone, in this lecture let us see the analysis of a single phase AC series RC circuit. So here I have taken a series circuit in which resistor and capacitor are connected in series and the voltage across resistance and capacitance are split into two different parts from the given supply voltage. Right, given supply voltage is being divided between both the resistor and capacitor in series. Now coming to the phasor diagram or phasor representation, we know that the total current flowing through both these elements is same. So that to draw the phasors of this circuit, I am taking the reference as current, right? So the total current I am taking it as reference. We know that the voltage across the resistor is in phase with the current through the resistor. So that I can draw, if it is my reference current, the voltage across a resistor will be in phase, right? VR. VR is equals to I into R. So this is in phase with the reference current I. But we know that the voltage across a capacitor VC is I into XC, where XC is nothing but what? Capacitive reactance. It is called as capacitive reactance. So this voltage leads current, right? Leads current by, sorry, it lags current, right? So VC lags current by pi by 2 radians, right? So in this, in capacitor, current leads the voltage, right? So voltage is lagging behind the current by 90 degrees. So that is represented in phasor like this. So this is the current, voltage is lagging behind, right? So this will be VC. VC is equals to what? I into XC. Now the total voltage of both resistor and capacitor is nothing but the resultant of these two phasors, so which can be obtained by drawing a parallelogram. So parallel phasors, right? Parallel to this I have drawn another phasor, and parallel to this VR I have drawn another phasor. So now this gives a parallelogram, and the resultant or diagonal of this parallelogram gives me the resultant, that is V is equals to I into Z, where this is angle between the resultant and angle between the reference and the resultant is called the phase angle phi, right? So this resultant can be given by, magnitude of this resultant is given by V is equals to under root of VR square plus VC square or not. So that is nothing but VR is nothing but IR square plus IXC square, which can be given by I into under root of R square plus XC square. So that is I into Z. So this is about voltage, resultant voltage V is equals to I into Z. So now from the triangle, now what is the triangle now? This is the triangle now. Impedance triangle, let me draw again. So this becomes my impedance triangle now, where this is IR, this is what? IXC, and this is what? IZ, right? So R, XC, Z, and this is the angle phi, right? So now from this triangle, tan phi is written as tan, opposite side, that is VC, by adjacent side, that is VR. Given, can be given by IXC by IR is nothing but XC by R. So X is nothing but 1 by omega C, right? So 1 by omega CR. So phase angle can be given by tan inverse 1 by omega RC. Right, this is the formula for finding out the phase angle in case of series RC circuit. So now let us go to finding out different parameters or finding out the behavior of a series RC circuit. Now if I assume the instantaneous voltage across this total circuit as V is equals to Vm sin omega t, then that implies I will be given by, instantaneous current will be given by I is equals to Im sin omega t plus phi r naught, as it is a capacitive circuit, right? So now we know that, now what we need to find out? We need to find out the instantaneous power P, which is given by small v. That is nothing but the product of instantaneous values of voltage and current, which can be given from Vm sin omega t into Im sin omega t plus phi. So multiplying and dividing by 2, we'll be getting Vm Im 2 sin omega t sin omega t plus phi, from where we will be getting the resultant as Vm Im by 2 cos phi minus cos 2 omega t plus phi. Same as in case of series RL circuit, there will be a constant term as well as a particular term such that it oscillates at double the frequency, 2 omega, that is 2 pi f. Also, average power can be given by V is equals, P is equals to Vi cos phi r naught, right? So, where I know that my V is nothing but I into Z, right? V is nothing but I into Z. And I is nothing but I, and cos phi. Cos phi from this is what? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. R by Z. Right? R by Z. From which I can write it as I square R R naught. So P is equals to I square R. We can write it as. Right? So that this is the different parameters. So, according to which a series RC circuit. Hope you have understood the concepts. Thank you.